We know you all have a lot of questions about the Manifest finale.
You must have a lot of feelings and a lot of questions.
We're gonna answer your burning questions right now.
I've always had a broad idea about what the ending was going to be, but it wasn't until I was riffing long and hard with my excellent staff of writers that it all came together.
How long have you known?
I didn't know, and I didn't bother to ask, and I don't think Jeff would have told me anyways.
Yeah, I had no idea.
We knew bits and pieces of how it was going to end because, you know, from the very beginning, I didn't want to know exactly what was going to happen to these characters.
I did know after episode 10 that I would be back, but I knew that there would be a way for Zeke to continue to be in the show. Obviously, it was hard to not be directly involved in figuring out this big mystery, but I love the stuff that I've had in season 4. When I read it and when Jeff told me about it, I was moved to tears.
I wouldn't want to end the show any other way. Being all together and wrapping this like incredible ride that we've all just had.
Yeah. She was a wreck.
Yeah, I was a wreck.
Some people actually were already guessing the ending because some people posted like photos like in an airport. And so then people were like, does this happen? And like the description they gave is like exactly what happens.
A lot of the fans almost exactly get it.
And I always try to stay away from even liking those tweets because I'm so nervous about people landing it and then it taking off out there. So I just stay away.
It's a very heavy ending. I mean, Angelina has been so self-righteous about all the things that she believes in and the actions that she's taking. And what I've liked about playing this character, even though she can be perceived as evil and destructive, is that she genuinely thinks that she's doing the right thing.
It was bittersweet. We really left it to the end to shoot it. Walking through the glow, I just felt like, here we go. Walking through the end.
The whole show's a mystery. You know, it starts off like, what is this? What's going on? It ends, what is this? What's going on?
I think that the fans will react to this ending pleasantly. I'm manifesting this for myself.
Yeah, it's for you.
I think that they're going to love Angelina all of a sudden, and I will be swarmed with an influx of love and affection on social media.
I mean, I'm very happy that Ben and Grace got to unite.
I really enjoyed watching Grace get her family back in a way that was just as it should be and without the consequence of knowing what everyone went through. I say that because I got to watch Josh and Athena film this reunion scene and there was just so much love and joy and family was reunited.
When they walk into that terminal and it's back into 2013, and she turns and waves at them. He says, are we in heaven? And for him, that was heaven, that she was there and the love of his life was back. And it was emotional and joyous.
Walking past Ben and Grace and not recognizing them or making eye contact with them when we have had really crucial scenes with each other over the year, it was surreal. It was just weird. The only fun part about it was that after they cut, Josh would just go, look at me!
I was so happy to see Ben and Grace reunited. I think their connection on screen and everything is just so beautiful, and they're both such amazing people on the show, off the show. So that, like when I was reading, it was really sweet.
Cal has been our emotional North Star from the very beginning. We've steered the mythology of the story through the eyes of Cal. It made a lot of sense to us to finish the story, to let the boy ultimately guide the father. Ben, to have his son tell him, it's okay, Dad. It's going to be okay.
They get to have their childhoods back. To me, that's the most satisfying.
There's the love triangle. There's people in the Jaqueline camp, and there's people in the Zakayla camp. Zakayla fans, they won. Congrats, congrats.
We have these two factions of really passionate people, which is so fun. Yes. I think the finale really does service both groups.
100%. I think they did a beautiful job at bringing it all together.
They really did.
It could have been the other way. With the whole Michaela Zeke thing, especially after the bomb he threw her way at the end of season 3. They tug us every way possible. One of the things I loved the most about this season was that he wants the best for her. In the midst of all that, he realizes how good this man has been to her.
There was no love lost between any of the characters, and the send-off for all of them was just selfless and
the way that Michaela gets to re-meet Zeke is fun because she has all the answers and he knows nothing. She kind of gets to take him on a new journey.
All these things that have been talked about and planted and stories that have gone away are now coming back.
And it's a huge full circle moment.
We come to discover that all the passengers of Flight 828 have been on a journey that has been a divine journey. We make clear that everything you've watched happened. This is real. We're not trying to mess with people's minds and say some of that was fantasy, some of that was reality. It's all real.
Hopefully they learn from their mistakes and they get this amazing thing that we would all love to have as a second chance. And they get a second chance at their life and a second chance of living differently, better, kinder, and knowing what they know now, that it's all connected and that we're all in this together, which I think is the ultimate message that the show is putting across.
Thank you guys so much for sticking with us for four seasons. We hope you enjoy the ending as much as we loved filming it.
Thanks, Manifestors. We love you.